The latest BBC Sport update.
We'll start with the second straight defeat for the Scottish champions Celtic. They lost to Rangers at the weekend and lost in the Europa League 3-1 to AC Milan in their first match last night. Mohamed Elyounoussi had given Celtic hope, pulling it back to 2-1, but Milan sealed it in injury time. Their manager, Celtic, Neil Lennon, was pretty encouraged, though, even in defeat.
People can be critical of the team on tonight's performance if they want, that's fine. Definitely deserve criticism at the weekend because we weren't anywhere near our best, but there's a lot of signs for me. I don't like losing, but a lot of good signs that we'll have another good season on that showing.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant goal, as Nicky says, from Kamar Roof from the halfway line for Rangers as they beat Standard Liège 2-0 away. It was his return to Belgium, used to play for Anderlecht. Thomas Partey was man of the match for Mikel Arteta's Arsenal, underlining exactly why he forked out £45 million for him on deadline day. The Ghana midfield was excellent in Arsenal's comeback 2-1 win at Rapid Vienna.
He looked really solid, really comfortable. I think he held midfield by himself in the second half as well. When we started to take more chances, I think he was fantastic and there's much more to come from him.
Yeah, really exciting looking player. Tottenham looked like they've unearthed one too. Carlos Vinicius played up front as a backup for Harry Kane. He looks a real handful. Got an assist in their 3-0 win over LASK. Gareth Bale also got an assist, forcing an own goal. Leicester had no Jamie Vardy, but they still got their biggest European win, 3-0 against Zorya Luhansk. And the Irish side Dundalk lost 2-1 to Molder. In the surprise result of the night, though, AZ Alkmaar of Holland had 13 players out because of COVID and still beat Napoli. Wales women thrashed the Faroe Islands 4-0 in their Euro 2021 qualifier as well. And one final football line, Notts County have pulled out of the FA Cup after a COVID outbreak in their squad. Accrington against Bristol Rovers has also been postponed after 8 Stanley players tested positive. Now, rugby union, England are supposed to be playing Barbarians on Sunday. Here's Hugo Monya.
This week is almost an illustration of the kind of turbulent life that we're all living under this coronavirus pandemic. We finally got confirmation of the Premiership final just yesterday, and now Sunday's England Barbarians game looks like to be in turmoil.
Yeah, the fixture now depends on whether players can be brought in. We should know by this afternoon. The Barbarians have breached their bubble protocol. They've had to send 12 players home. Wakefield beat Huddersfield 18-14. Castleford beat Hull 38-24 in Super League. It has also been announced that the grand final will be played at Hull's KCOM Stadium next month instead of at Old Trafford. England's Tyrrell Hatton is 7 under par, one shot off the leader Sebastian Munoz at the PGA tournament in California. Laurie Cantor, yesterday of England, shot a 60, a 12 under par opening round. He's 4 shots clear after round one at the Italian Open, and Mel Reid is the best of the Brits on the LPGA Tour, 4 shots off the lead in Georgia. Sunrisers Hyderabad beat the Rajasthan Royals in the IPL. Britain's Theo Gegenhardt is in contention to win the Giro d'Italia. He was second on stage 18 yesterday. It all finishes this weekend. And the Premier League darts champion Glenn Durrant is out of the International Open after testing positive for the virus.
BBC Sport.